My name is Kathreena Kurian. I'm a consultant neuropathologist, so that means for a living I diagnose brain tumours. The problem in this country is clear. We have 9,000 adults with a tumour starting within the brain and about 1,500 children. And the problem is, after 5 years, only 20% of those patients are alive, so we need to do better for these patients. The other thing is that now patients are surviving tumours from elsewhere in the body, so breast and lung tumours, for example, which are travelling to the brain, which is obviously devastating. So Bristol is a huge centre for treating brain tumour patients. We have neurosurgeons here, we have academics, and our ambition is to have the Bristol Brain Cancer Centre of Excellence, which I will lead. We have a research group here, and the main focus is to find out why you have a brain tumour in the first place. At the moment, why you get a brain tumour is not very well known. There aren't any good risk factors, apart from if you've had previous radiotherapy or in very rare genetic cases. So we need to find out why you have one in the first place so we can try and prevent it. The other thing I know is that when I diagnose two patients, give them the same diagnosis, they can behave very, very differently with the treatments that we give them. So what we want to understand is how one patient's tumour is different from another, and can we personalise therapies for these patients? Because at the moment, if you have a brain tumour, we take it out using neurosurgery and then we give you chemo radiotherapy, which is obviously very difficult to take. And what happens is, although the chemo radiotherapy kills most of the tumour cells, it leaves some cells behind, and what normally happens is this tumour regrows. That's what happens to practically all of our patients. Now, there is a new generation of targeted inhibitors which can be specific to an individual tumour. So what we want to do is match an individual patient with a targeted therapy, so-called personalised medicine, and that's our aim for brain tumours, and I'm sure it will revolutionise the outcome for this group of patients who at the moment have a very poor outcome.